What's up, everyone? It's Cassers here, and it's time to play Subnautica. Oh, oh, oh! Oh, man, oh, man. How's it going, everybody? How's it going? I hope you guys are all having an amazing, amazing day today. I'm having a super exciting day. The prawn suit update. You'd think I'd be able to read it since it's right in front of me. The prawn update was just released yesterday morning, and I am amazingly excited to jump right back into the ocean planet here and start a brand new survival save with you guys. Now, the prawn suit update isn't just going to be the exosuit. It's also got some expanded material for the Aurora, the big spaceship. So this is super, super cool. I cannot wait to go and kind of explore that again and just check out the new content. Man. So exosuit, new things in the Aurora. These are definitely going to be our first kind of goals early on in the game. We probably won't get to them today, but it's going to be happening within the first few episodes. But all right, the prawn update released. Now available, the pressure reactive waterproof nano suit. Woo, that's a mouthful. Or the prawn suit. The prawn is capable of diving to great depths and withstanding severe heat. Blah, 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 blah. We could read more if we wanted to, but we're not gonna, because it's time to play. Why is the water coming through the floor if we're on the ship? Oh man, it's not good times on the Aurora, guys. Look at that funky water. We're in the air right now. Why is there water? Flippity, no! Oh my gosh, I don't feel so good. Oh, there's a fire! Could you even imagine? Let me out of this chair. Oh my goodness, okay. All right, so Major Mayday right away. Let's pick this guy up. Oh, okay, right click to shoot the stuff. Come on. Oh, can we put you out? Oh, I'm on fire! I thought I just had to get closer to put it out. Could light me on fire, you stinking thing. Okay, is crisis averted? Our first crisis is averted. Did we make it?
Greetings, survivor. Great job not dying. This is the first survival in emergency situations. You have been issued this personal data assistant. The interface visible now will organize your inventory, display currently available construction blueprints, and holds other valuable information. Please take a moment to familiarize yourself with it.
Alright, are you done talking, Sheila? Holy crap, she is long-winded. And she has, like, a different voice. I don't know how I feel about that. I kind of feel sad. I like Sheila. Alright, so initializing, blah, 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 blah. Good job not dying. Gosh, that was really funny. And welcome. Let's do this. Alright, we're in an all-environment protection suit. And it's gonna protect us from all sorts of super bad things out there. Oh, a slimline build for maximum freedom of movement. That's good to know. That's really good to know. Oh, we have a readme. There's all sorts of cool information here that we can read, and I'm probably going to go ahead and do that off camera just because it could get super boring if I sit here and just read it all to you. Survival 101. I feel like we should read this, guys. Right? We don't know how to survive. So number one, administer first aid if required. Check. Got it, man. 2. Survey the environment for threats and resources. Cool. Check and check. Take inventory of available materials and supplies and decide on rations. Alright, I'm not going to read all these. You know what? This is like basic stuff. I guess we could look at the Aurora here. If you guys want to pause, go ahead and read this. Totally feel free, man. Yeah. Adrian Arm phase gate installation, 3-year operation time. Aho! Sustained heavy damage in orbit of planet 4546B.
Increased local radiation levels. Trend is consistent with ongoing degradation of the Aurora's dark matter drive core due to damage sustained during collision. Continuing to monitor.
All right, so there's some degradation happening over on the Aurora. Let's take a peek here. We've got a nutrient block. Let's go ahead and eat that guy right away. Bam! 100%. And we're also going to drink a water. Switch container and drink it. All right, and we also have some flares. We'll just leave those there for now. Oh, I guess I didn't need to drink the water. That was my health that was down. Derp! All right, this guy, can we do a thing? No, because this place is, like, super damaged. All right. Before we jump out into the ocean, I'm just kind of peeking at our fabricator. I just want to see if there's anything that's just, like, standing out as a super new thing. And it looks like no. All right, let's get into the ocean, guys. Oh my goodness, the big blue. How I have missed you. I just love this game! Alright, zero life signs detected in 100 meter range. So, it's the beginning of Subnautica. I absolutely love the beginning of this game. Pretty much all we gotta do right now is just kind of swim around, gather up a bunch of resources so we can get some of the beginning sort of things going on here. We've gotta get ourselves a scanner. We gotta make ourselves an oxygen tank. Crap, we only got 12 air. Emergency. Let's go breathe!
10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
I was on it, Sheila. You don't gotta be telling me. Does the Aurora seem bigger? It looks absolutely massive. Now, I know in this update they added a bunch of other rooms or something like that, so I'm super excited to go and check that out. That'll be one of our early goals here, is to get a radiation suit going on and then go and check out the brand new Aurora kind of things. Now, what am I doing? I've got one titanium, I've got two quartz. Let's just kind of fill up our hands here and then we'll go back and see if we can make like a knife, make a O2 tank. Ooh, I'll grab that salt. I'll take everything I can get right now, man. I will take everything except floaters. Floaters can just go. I don't even need them. Oh, fish, be my food. Boomerang! Come to me! Oh! You're not even that fast!
10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Alright, we're gonna breathe again. We're gonna be super good. Life pods are equipped with some stuff, but I missed that message. Okay, I missed the message. It's fine. Ooh, I want that quartz. I'm just trying to get a good little handful of titanium and quartz here, and hopefully we can just kind of make it. What the crap was that? Did you just hear, like, a weird laugh? What was... Was that Barnaby? Barnaby, dude! Do you make a new noise? Oh, well, that was kind of gross. Excuse yourself, man. Just gonna burp right in my face. Woo! Maybe it wasn't him. I could've swore I heard, like, a laugh or something.
Oxygen remaining.
So it's super cool, it's super cool. I love playing Subnautica because every time that you come back in the game, it's almost guaranteed that something is gonna be different. Now, I am playing in the stable version this time. I know in the past, was it two or three seasons? I had been playing in experimental. And as awesome as it is to kind of get the new things as they come out, it's also sort of frustrating. So there'd be like certain times where you would get in and be falling through the floor of your sea base and not able to swim in the ocean. Oh my god, look at the peepers jumping! Will they do it again? That's so cool, the little fish are jumping on the surface. But yeah, it was kind of frustrating trying to do things in experimental because there'd be certain days where I'd be trying to record an episode and my Cyclops would just decide to dive to the bottom of the ocean and, like, start filling with water randomly. You know, stupid things like that. So I switched back to stable, and I think it's gonna be a good time. It'll help out for the season lasting a little bit longer, and overall just being a little bit less funky for you guys, I hope. I hope so. Bam, let's get that scrap. How's our inventory space?
Emergency. 10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Oh, can I use this? Are we going faster? Or are we going the same speed? I can't really tell. Hold on, let's do this without holding any keys. Oh, look at that! We are totally propelling ourselves with the stupid fire hydrant. That's pretty cool. We can use that to kind of get ourselves back up to the surface faster. That's so cool, man. All right, so we've got kind of a little bit of things going on here. We've got a good little amount of quartz.
Degradation of the Aurora's drive core may cause a quantum detonation. calculating risk assessment. Death by malnourishment, 7%. By physical injury, 11%. By exposure to radioactive crash site materials, 19%. If the drive core is breached, probability of death increases to 65%.
All right, so Sheila's giving us all kinds of warnings, and we will probably get killed by radiation, according to her math. And she's all into those numbers, so I trust her math. She's like that one that helps you out with the homework all the time in class. You know, unless you're one of the smart kids and you don't need help. In that case, keep on rocking your life. what the crap were we doing before she interrupted us? Sweet! We just got a piece of copper. I think that's our first copper found, guys. And we are still, like, up there on the inventory
emergency
space.
10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Oh, 10 seconds. What is that? Oh, this is so cool. There's, like, a huge chunk of the wreck right here. So I'm kind of looking to find more scrap metal. I know we usually need, like, a ton of titanium right at the beginning. So I'm trying to just get as much of that. It's becoming night. It's so dark. Oh my goodness. Maybe I should have grabbed one of those flares. That might have helped me. Snap blue. Oh man, look at this. There's like a menu board here. Once I get the scanner, I wonder if I'll be able to like scan that and use it as a decoration. Is that more scrap? Ooh, yes it is. Super cool. Let's go and breathe on this brain coral a little bit.
10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Sheila, I know. I'm breathing right now. You silly. Uh-oh. I don't know if you guys can see it because it is so super dark, but there are some jerkfish off in the distance, aka stalkers. Inventory full. Okay, and it is full. Let's go and get back to the escape pod since it is night. Well, that was kind of funky. Do you hear the music totally just cut out, like instantly? Can I do anything here? Oh, there's a fragment in there!
10 seconds of oxygen remaining.
All right. Let's quit horsing around, go to the surface a little bit, and get to the escape pod. So now that we have a lot of the starting supplies here, we're going to be able to kind of get some of the basic tools and stuff going on. There's not really like an order that you have to do things in, but there's definitely kind of a good thing. There's like a good amount of things you want to do first to succeed. You know what I'm saying? So I think the first thing that we need to do is we need to come over and convert all of our scrap. Check one. Oh man, we're making a list. Checking it twice. Turning all that metal into something nice. I feel like there's an extra layer of like cheesiness on me today, so I'm sorry if I'm being super, super cheesy. I'm just so excited to play this game again. All right, so we've got the titanium. That's magnesium. Let's see, what do we need to make? I want to make a scanner. We need a battery and titanium. What do we need for a battery? Just some mushrooms and... Oh, I thought we needed copper. Oh, we do need copper. I was looking at the power cell. All right, so we just need to grab one more mushroom and we can actually go ahead and make a battery. And we already have the titanium. So let's just pop out super fast, grab ourselves one of these mushrooms and make ourselves the scanner. And then we can start learning about all the creatures in the ocean. Bam. Oh, wait. Was my inventory full? We only need two. We got this. We're amazing. All right. That's not what I meant. I meant to grab this thing. Oh, we'll back up a little bit so it's not all giant. And we need to make a battery. All right. First battery of the season. Check and check. Now we just need to come down to equipment and make our scanner. Now, before, when I had started my last season, they had just given us this tool right away. Like, we didn't have to do anything for it. Oh man, we can scan stuff now. Awesome! Use welder to repair. So kind of our second goal, I think, is going to be to try and get a welder going, like, stat. We need to get a welder going on. Last season, this life pod totally left us, man. Like, it was here one episode, and the next episode it was, like, 7,000 meters away that way. So we're going to keep it with us this time. I think it's going to help us out a lot in the long run to have this as a survival tool. And so yeah, we need to come back in here and we need to check and see what we need to make ourselves a welder. Magnesium crash, crash fish powder,
warning,
and titanium.
Radiation readings exhibit characteristics consistent with total degradation of the Aurora's dark matter drive core. A quantum detonation will occur with a probability of 85.5%. Advise observing a 1 kilometer safety range.
How far is 1 kilometer? All right, so Sheila's telling us more about the Aurora. I'm gonna go ahead and make ourselves an oxygen tank here because that's gonna be super helpful in our survival. And I also wanna see what we need to make a survival knife. All right, we need silicone rubber, which if I'm not mistaken, we need creep vine for. All right, so we've gotta head over to the kelp biome and cut a couple of seeds. Okay, super cool. Let's go ahead. And let's pop some of the stuff into this container for right now. That way, if anything should happen to us out there, it's all kind of saved in this inventory and we're not gonna lose it. Now, how's our stuff doing? We're not doing the greatest on the water. I think we're gonna go ahead and take that guy right now. Bam. And we're gonna leave the nutrient block here. I am gonna take the flare with us in case we end up in a super dark spot and we have to see. All right, so we need to head to the kelp biome. We need to get crash fish powder, and that's kind of our goals right now. We'll get the welder going, we'll get the knife going, and absolutely perfect timing! The sun just came up. Oh my goodness. Oh, I love this game. Look at how beautifully gorgeous. Oh my gosh. So if we go this kind of way, we should run into the kelp biome. Can I use this to like get there faster? I don't know what else we would use this for, so unless fires can break out in your sea base, I don't know. But for right now, we'll just use it to kind of get places a little bit quicker. I don't have the sea glide yet. Oh, I do have the scanner though. Maybe I should be keeping an eye out for fragments. All right, we'll go ahead and scan you. We can learn about the metal scrap. Oh, look at that. There's a new icon when you learn things. Cool, man. To talk about it? Data downloads. Analysis confirms this wreckage is from the Aurora. Outer layers of the material have oxidized, suggesting that it has been heated to over 1200 degrees Celsius. Wow, that is super hot. This pattern is consistent with the hull disintegration during atmospheric entry. Inner layers contain enough residual titanium to be reclaimed at the fabricator. All right, okay, cool, man. They gave us all kinds of information about that scrap. And I almost kind of ran out of air while I was reading about it. It's fine. It's fine. We've got 75 oxygen now after making that tank, so we're doing pretty good there. And I kind of want to watch out for fragments as we swim over to the kelp. Oh, look at my guy. It's like he's got a camera in his hand or something. See our awesome shadow? It looks like we're recording ourselves. We're like just recording a vlog right now. Day one in the ocean. It's a mysterious place, full of beautiful creatures and plant life, most of which are bioluminescent. I'm sorry, I'm like going into this narrative mode now.
Emergency. Seismic readings suggest a quantum detonation has occurred in the Aurora's drive core. The central dark matter reactor will reach a supercritical state.
I want to get on the escape pod.
10.
T-minus. Get me there, get me there, get me there, get me there.
6.
Dang, I wanted to be on top of the escape pod. Oh yeah, you see all those chunks flying and everything? Oh my goodness. All right, everybody, our situation has gotten real. The Aurora has exploded and left debris all over the ocean. And now we need to clean up all the litter because this is actually Captain Planet. No, I'm just totally kidding. All right, let's pick up the salvage. I don't know why I wanted to get on top of that stupid pod so badly, but I wanted to watch it from kind of like out of the water. You know what I mean? Now let's see if we could get over to the kelp forest and get ourselves a little bit of creepvine seeds. I feel a lot safer once I have a knife. I'm also kind of keeping my ears open. If we get close to one of those little crash plant dealy dads, we should be able to kind of hear them growling. They make a little noise. All right, let's go ahead. Ooh, sea glide fragment. I'm all about that. The sea glide is a personal transportation device designed for use in oceanic environments. Capable of speeds up to 10 meters in a second in standing water, displays basic topographical data for aid in charting cave systems. Replaceable battery. Awesome! We're learning so much! I just love the PDA, man. It's like so cool. Feel like such a scientist on this world. Alright, we need to breathe a little bit more. And we are here at the kelp biome, so that is pretty cool. Once we have the sea glide going, we're gonna be completely set for kind of beginner's survival here. I just really want to make sure we get the welder going and stop our escape pod from drifting away. Ooh, a crash plant. Oh! Sweet, we avoided damage. Can I get the stuff? Oh, a crash egg. What's a crash egg? I don't think that's the crash flower. Let's try another one. Whoop! Okay, we took a little damage there. Powder! Sweet! Okay, so it looks like they drop eggs and powder now. That is definitely new. Whoop!
30 seconds of oxygen.
They're so angry! Just stop! Just stop! Oh, he went after Barnaby! He's so angry he went after Barnaby. Alright, oh my goodness, oh my goodness. Let's go and see how's our inventory doing now. So that's super cool. We got the crash fish powder, which used to just be called crash powder. So we'll be able to make our, whatchamacallit, our welder, because we also have all the salt we need to make ourselves some magnesium. Last thing we gotta do before we go to our little base here. Ooh, I don't think I can cut any creep vine to make silicone, can I? Or do I just need the cluster? I think I might just need the cluster. Let's go and check it out. Ooh, we got fragments down here. I didn't mean to take out that. I meant to take out the scanner. All right, let's do a little breathing off the purple brain coral while we learn about it. Oh, look at that amazing image right there. That is so cool with the illustration. A permanent growing colony of microscopic organisms, this coral species has adapted to filter carbon dioxide from the environment, using carbon to build the colony and expelling oxygen from specialized exhaust funnels. This is so cool, man! With all the little images and the, like, the extended information in the PDA, I'm just absolutely fascinated by all this stuff right now. Do we already know this? Oh yeah, solar panel unlocked. And we're gonna learn about a limestone chunk, because that's like, why wouldn't we do that? We're just amazing right now. And we got some more copper, that's super awesome. If we could get a chunk of silver while we're down here, that would be kind of a game changer. That would sort of make our entire beginning of the game a lot more streamlined. We've got brain coral right down there so we can breathe. Uh-oh. Jerkfish chomping. Did you guys hear those teeth? I need to grab a couple of seed clusters. Let's see. Inventory full.
30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Let's see if we can get into some of these bubbles here. Alright, you guys just hang out. I gotta watch out. Those jerkfish can really hurt me. Oh! Why? Can I scan you? And avoid you? Master avoidance. Let's do this. For science! Oh, he's got a brother. Oh, she's like, no, dude, I'm his sister. You just call me a bro. Come on now, scan it, scan it. How much do we need to scan it? Oh my gosh, why do I need to scan you for so long? This is ridiculous! Okay, we learned. I'm done learning. School's out. Open hands so we can swim faster. Up, up, up.
Dip, 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 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Oh my god, I only have 6% health. That was terrible. What the crap? I totally almost killed myself, everybody. It wouldn't be the beginning of Subnautica if I didn't do that, right? So cool. Mission success. We almost died. We've got our crash powder. We have everything we need to make the welder and a knife. That's the other thing. I don't know why I'm so scatterbrained today. So let's get back and make those couple of awesome survival tools, and I think we're gonna be all set, man. This is how we do it. After we get our life pod repaired, our next goal is definitely going to be our sea glide and then a builder, because those are going to be the super next helpful things in survival. I don't know if any of this is like absolutely redundant information for you guys, but for anyone who's new to the game and kind of wondering how it works, I just want, you know, to kind of help. Can I scan any of these plants? With three. A veined nettle. Okay. The writhing weed. I'm all about plant science. Acid mushrooms. Alright, we used to be able to eat these, believe it or not. Which I always thought was weird. I'm like, acid mushrooms don't sound like they'd be too super healthy to be eaten. You know, it'd be bad for your teeth, man. It wouldn't be good for enamel. But yeah, now we can't eat them, and they are kind of detrimental to grow near bases. Let's go and... You know what? I'm sorry. ADD is happening right now. I need to see if we can scan that sign. I just gotta know. Can I learn that billboard? Could I have baked potatoes, coleslaw, and chicken and all that? I guess I didn't need to scan that one because I already know the solar panel. Is this scrap or is this just like a chunk? That is a huge chunk of scrap metal. Holy man. Alright, now if I remember right... No, that's just another solar panel. Alright, what are you? Okay, so I can't scan it. Darn, I was kind of hoping I could. Is there anything in here I could scan? That's some scrap metal. It's kind of cool that they're starting to put a lot of stuff inside of these little cargo things. Some of them are still inaccessible, of course, but a lot more of them seem to have stuff now. Inventory is 100% full. Let's get back to the life pod and make our things. And hopefully there'll be like a health kit sitting there too. Alright, home sweet home, back at the escape pod, and I just need to free up a couple of inventory slots, so I'm gonna put these creature eggs away, grab ourselves a medical kit. And now we're back up, we're away from 6% health, so I feel way, way better about that. And this should make us another, health kit here, and I don't know, it's like 10 or 15 minutes or something like that? But anywho... We gotta come over, and we've gotta make ourselves some titanium, get a few things converted here, and get a couple of stuffs going on. Alright, so we needed one silicone to make a silly knife, and we need a magnesium to make a welder. I think that's all the part kind of things we need here. So let's come back down to tools, and welder. Bam! That's what I'm talking about. So this is going to help us out a lot in the beginning. It's going to keep us in one place. And our survival knife is self-explanatory. That's going to help us fend ourselves off from predators. There's certain things like creep vine that we have to have the knife for. And now that this fire extinguisher is depleted, I'm going to go ahead and store that as well. We're going to eat that last nutrient block. Store you. And eat you. Bam. Alright, so now... I think we are rocking. Alright, we got the welder. Let's put the knife on one. And let's do a little bit of repairing, man. Let's get this thing all ship shape. What do I do? Just this? Alright, there we go. I had to get a little bit closer and our weld percentage had started going up. Awesome. Let there be light! It's still kind of smoking in here. I guess it's because this thing is kind of broken. Bam! There we go. Oh, can I do anything with you? Can I get you to quit smoking? I wonder if I could put the fire extinguisher back in this holder. You guys know what I'm saying? Alright. Alright, so there's a new message. I think I'm gonna leave that for right now. I wanna look at the status thing here. Status? Okay. Hull integrity? Okay. Secondary systems online. Flotation devices deployed. Environment. Uncharted ocean planet. Oxygen and nitrogen atmosphere. Waterborne bacteria levels are high. Ooh. And attempting to scan emergency frequencies. All right, I think that is going to go ahead and do it for today, guys. We've got a pretty good start. We got our welder going, we got our scanner going, a little bit of a knife and some air tanks. I think we're rocking, man. We're totally setting ourselves up for success here. So as always, thank you guys so much for coming and hanging out. I seriously appreciate it. I hope you guys have an amazing rest of your day. I will too. I'll catch you next time. And this is Cassers out.
Up a tree, clinging to a cloud.